Tonight, the Oxford Girls Lacrosse Program hosts the Regina Satellites. On behalf of the 2023 OHS Girls Lacrosse Program, Coach Marshall would like to thank and congratulate this year's senior class. Raina, Anna, Ava, Reagan, Rachel, Gracie, Tia, and Cayman. You have contributed so much to the program. We wish you the best and we will miss you all. Now let us introduce our seniors. Our first senior is number 6, Captain Cayman Anderley. Cayman is escorted by her mom and dad, Jennifer and Clint. Cayman is a 2-year varsity defender. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is the connections she has made with the girls on the team. Her favorite memory is when she and Reagan, the 2 defenders, each scored a goal in a single game. Cayman is off to Saginaw Valley in the fall to study pre-dentistry. Let us recognize number 6, Cayman Anderley. Next up is number 8, Tia D. Anastasio. Tia cannot be here this evening, but we'd like to recognize number 8, Tia D. Anastasio. Our next senior is number 10, Rachel Albrecht. Rachel is escorted by her parents, Mike and Ann. Rachel has been a midfielder on varsity for 2 years. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is being able to push herself to be the best person and athlete she can be. Her favorite lacrosse memory is bonding with the team and becoming good friends with them. Rachel is attending Oakland Community College for emergency medical services. Let us recognize number 10, Rachel Albrecht. Next up is number 11, Captain Reagan Brightshoe. She is being escorted by her mom, Lene, dad, Alan, and brother, Tommy. Reagan is a 4-year varsity defender. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is the team dynamic and the friendships she has made. Her favorite memory is the epic ground ball battle with Natalie Lindstrom. Reagan is attending Michigan State University to study environmental biology to help save the planet. Let us recognize number 11, Reagan Brightshoe. Our next senior is number 14, Captain Raina St. Juliana. Raina is being escorted by her mom and dad, I and Steven. Raina has been on varsity for 2 years and plays both midfield and attack. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is all her teammates, and her favorite memory is the Hana Night. Raina will be attending Michigan State University in the fall to study psychology. Let us recognize number 14, Raina St. Juliana. Next up is number 19, Ava Vogler. Ava is escorted by her mom, Julie. Ava has played attack on varsity for 2 years. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is the people on the team and getting to play with everyone. And this is her favorite sport. Her favorite memory is when Raina missed on an open net. Ava will be attending Oakland Community College for 1 year before transferring to the University of Chicago to study political science. Let us recognize number 19, Ava Vogler. Our next senior is number 21, Captain Gracie Phelps. Gracie is being escorted by her parents, Preston and Rachel Phelps. Gracie has been on varsity for 2 years and plays midfield. Her favorite thing about lacrosse is the friendships she's made and the people she's met. She loves spending time with her team and getting to know each and every one of them, as well as making memories. Her favorite lacrosse memory was when the team went to Reagan's and made bracelets and ate fire salsa. Gracie will be attending Rochester University in the fall, studying exercise science. Let us recognize number 21, Gracie Phelps. Our final senior is number 23, Anna Vogler. Anna is being escorted by her mother, Julie. Anna plays midfield and has been on varsity for 2 years. Anna's favorite thing about lacrosse is winning with her favorite people. Her favorite memory is when she, Ava, and Ellie Horn were late for the bus because they were watching Big Time Rush last year. Anna will be attending Penn State University to study forensic psychology. Let us recognize number 23, Anna Vogler. Congratulations to our girls lacrosse senior class of 2023. We wish you the best of luck in all the successes the future has to hold.
Hi, I'm Joseph Calhoun.
I'm Jebediah Calhoun.
And we're here for OCTV's coverage of the girls' varsity lacrosse game against the Regina Satellites. It's senior night tonight. You're a senior, so you know how important it is. It's rite of passage. All you young folks moving on to bigger and better things. Tonight we're facing off against the Regina Satellites, who are coming in with a 4-10 record. We're currently sitting at a 7-10 record and 6-2 in the white division. Senior night here. They're coming off of two losses in a row, so hopefully, you know, a win in the standings would be nice. And then we're going to play one more home game, a playoff game against Fenton, and hopefully we can move on from there. We've been watching the warm-ups, and I think we can overtake this team. Jeb, how are you feeling tonight?
I'm feeling great, yeah. Watching them warm up, and yeah, feeling confident, feeling like we got this.
I think so, too. We're coming off them two losses, so hey, man, that win's right around the corner, and hopefully another win to follow against Fenton. We're going to go down that big block O down there and watch the game.
The Satellites are coached by John Delisola. The Wildcats are coached by Mr. Trevor Marshall and assisted by Macy McDevitt. Tonight's officials are Doug Bohannon and Brad Thomas. Enjoy the game, everyone. Good luck, girls.
And so we got the Catholic League Satellites coming in, like I said, with a record of 4-10. Looking at the warm-ups, I'm like, hey, this team, obviously they got a playoff game, so we know that they're capable. Always fun to watch this team score a lot of points real quick.
Yeah.
And here we go. Ball's up in the air. Looks like it takes an Oxford bounce, and it sure does. Here we go, right up the field, just like normal. This is what we do.
Yeah.
As Anna Vogler, 23, pushed it, but the defensive player poked it out there. Swooped up. Evelyn. Sauden. Junior. Skylar Laney over the middle. Bounce shot. just a little high and outside and out of the back of the end zone.
Not
the Satellites will take over. Oh, no, I'm sorry. Here comes Honda St. Juliana, or Reina St. Juliana. Loses the ball. Looks like a whistle. Going to get a free shot here. Again, it's Reina, number 14. Here comes the attack. Reina with a goal right away.
Wow.
Didn't take long, did it, Jeb?
No, it did not. Not even, just about
a little over a minute and 14 seconds.
And that's a goal by Reina St. Juliana.
Reina came right out here and scored. Nice. Beautiful
she
thing
did.
There.
Making the score of the Oxford Wildcats, 1. Regina Satellite, 0.
That was quick. Hey, that's hopefully that stays like that. You know, what was the final score of that JV game? It was like last
was
I looked
crazy.
Like 16-1.
Yeah,
it was. And during the warm-ups, like I said, I was like, man, our girls are just look at them though. She's coming right down there.
Yeah,
she's pushing it on the attack. That's Neely Taylor, junior for the Satellites. She came right down. She just didn't play at all around that one. Oh. Shot, pass was missed. Scooped right back up by the Satellites, though. That's Lauren Gaff. She passes it out to Olivia De La Soda. That must be the coach's daughter there. Got a whistle. Looks like it's going to go against the Satellites. Nope, it's against Oxford. I'm sorry. Satellites going to get a free shot here. That's Jessica Sakura, junior for Regina. On the attack, bounce shot, high of the goal. Ball's loose, scooped up, whistle. Going to go against the Satellites and Oxford to take over at about the 5. Here they come, moving right up the field. Cayman Anderley. Loses the ball. Got a whistle. Going to be against Regina again. Wildcats have maintained possession.
Love to see it.
Yeah, look at them. They just keep poking it out, though. They keep getting them from behind. Keep pickpocketing the ladies, don't they?
Yeah. Yes, they do.
Like I said earlier, 1-0 lead is a beautiful thing. Started out early.
Yeah. Very early.
Oh, nice move, but even better save. That's Kylie. Kylie Johnson in goal, number 44 for the Wildcats, doing what she does. Got a whistle, another free shot for the Satellites here. That'd be number 9, Ella. How do you say that, Jeb?
I would butcher that if I tried.
Yeah, I think we'd all butcher that. Wysoszewski? Gosh, damn, what do you say? Ooh, what a shot and a goal there. That was Lauren Gaff with the goal. This young lady's name, what do you say that says? He said, yeah. Yep. He's not going to attempt either.
We shy with the names, we're sorry.
Yeah, that's, man, I need that.
Yeah, there's been a few mess-ups, I think, in our run here.
Well,
oh, they scored.
I'm not going to try to play on the name. Lauren Gaff with the goal. The upstairs guys with the gaff on the headsets. Ball's in the air. We're going to keep playing this game, even though we can't pronounce that young lady's name.
Yeah.
Might have to ask. Ooh, got a whistle, and that's definitely going to go against the Satellites. Yeah, hold on a minute there. What? How do you get mowed over and the whistle go against you? I don't. Maybe she was
you
a blocking foul.
You fell wrong.
Must have been a blocking foul or something. Like, hey, what happened there?
Yeah, that's strange.
There she is, Lauren Gaff. She's got the goal for them. Tied it up 1-1. Just under 21 minutes to go here.
You know,
in
I'm
the
not
first
sure
half?
I know what a satellite is because I'm thinking the dish on the house, and it's a crown, and I'm assuming that's not correct.
No, that crown must be because I think they're in the Catholic League. Satellite is anything that orbits a planet, and it could be a satellite, as we know, like transmitting signals, or it could be a rock or a piece of space debris. Anything that's orbiting a body, a heavenly body, would be a satellite. Ooh, big shot from St. Juliana, and it's just north of the goal. Going to go out of the end zone and back to the Wildcats. Oh, no. I'm sorry. See, that's what I don't understand. Sometimes it goes out of the back of the goal. It goes to the home team and or the team, the attacking team, and then sometimes it goes to the defensive team. And
yeah.
I can't make out why. Another whistle. Looks like it's going to be out of bounds and back to the Wildcats here. Rayner with the inbounding the ball here on the attack. Nice pass over the middle. Just a little too high. It's going to go out of bounds on the north side of the field. The Satellites will take over on the 18-yard line here. Yes, and you know what? It makes sense, though. The Regina Satellites are heavenly bodies, right? Like,
yeah.
You know, that religious tie-in there.
Yeah.
Just a hair over 19 minutes to go here. Here comes the Regina Satellites on the attack. She moved right up the field. That's number 16, Jessica Sikora. She did that earlier. That's who brought it up last time, wasn't it? Or was it number 15, Neely Taylor? We're going to have to watch both of those two ladies. Nice defense there from Anna Vogler. Satellites slow it down, try to reset the offense. And we're just kind of standing around. There's Neely Taylor. Nice defense, though. Fiona, number 3, scooping it up. Oh, got a whistle. Gonna go against Oxford.
Interesting.
All right, here we go. Back on the attack. Right out of the back of the end zone. And the Wildcats to take over. Now, you know what? It occurred to me, if it's a pass out of the back of the end zone, is that when it becomes a exchange of possessions? And when you shoot it out of the back of the end zone, it's not? Whistle against Oxford. Going to get a free shot here? Nope, they're going to take it back reset it back behind the goal line as the official gets everyone into the position. And the whistle starts the game back up. 17 and a half minutes to go here in the first half. 1-1 tie. Been a couple of quick goals early.
How come they reset it? I'm confused.
I'm not sure. You know, I'm learning. You know, like the first time I ever broadcast with Bill, he asked me, he said, can you broadcast with me? And normally I'm a tech guy. Oh, shot is good. There she went. That's Jessica Sikora. That's one of them young ladies I was telling you to keep an eye on, Jeb.
Yeah.
Making it 2-1. Regina Satellites over the Wildcats. 17-11 to go. So he asked me, really, and I was doing what you do, or what you did like last year when I brought you on board. Gonna redo that one. I was looking up stats and reading information about, you know, lacrosse,
right.
How it's the most rapid growing sport in high school sports. Gonna reset this. And how, like, young people are just of both sexes, male and female, gravitating to this sport. And I can see why. It seems like it's a lot of fun to play.
Yeah, for sure.
It's a lot of cardio. You're definitely running, man.
Yeah, and for sure.
That's us on the attack right there. That's Lexi Yankee, number 22, moving it right up the field with ease, coming her back around the goal. And the shot is good. Nice.
Yes.
Tied it up 2-2. That was Abigail Snable on the attack, the attacker. junior. Tying it up 2-2. 16:31 to go here in the first.
Love to see it.
Got some fans down there, huh?
Yeah, pretty loud. Aw, the JV game has a lovely little piece of pizza. And they're all watching Varsity, which is nice.
That's nice. Go hit them up from the breadsticks, man.
Yeah, yeah, I could go for a crazy bread right
now. Share some of that with OCTV coverage over here.
Yeah.
You know, we're some hungry guys up here.
Yes, we are.
Yeah, all the time.
Never turn on a slice of pizza.
I don't trust anybody that says they don't like pizza, man. You're under suspicion immediately with me. I'm like, what? You don't eat pizza.
Yeah, that's pretty crazy.
What planet you come from? What rock did you crawl out from underneath? I don't know. But I'm keeping my eye on you like I'm keeping my eye on 15 and 16. That's Neely Taylor and Jessica Sikora for the Satellites. That young lady right there, too, number 24. Lauren Gaff, she's got a goal. Right over the middle, and good. It's good. That's Jessica Sikora again with her second goal of the night, making it 3-2. Jeez. Regina over the Wildcats, 15:42 to go in the first. There was it was Jessica Sikora again. 13, 8, 16. Yep, that's her second one of the night.
Crazy.
Ball's up in the air at the big block O here in Oxford. OHS scooped up by the Satellites. Here they come back on the attack. That's number 11. Oh, got a whistle. Bella. Vushau? Bella Vushau?
Maybe.
Vushau?
These are some intimidating last names.
Exactly. Oh. Behind the goal. It looked like it went in, but it was behind the net. Come on, Oxford. Get it out of there. Ball's free in front of there. There you go, Kylie. Get it out of there, 44. Move it on down the field. Here we go. Ooh. I say it took a Regina bounce, but no, it's still loose. Ball's up in the air right by the big block O. St. Juliana put it. Oh, it's still loose in the whistle. Going to go against Oxford. Satellites take over. Oh, look at her. Get in here. Steal it, young lady. Got to get a call on that. Two whistles in a row. That's okay. She got aggressive. I love it. It's senior night. Get it. Get it in. Going to roll out of bounds, and it's going to go to the Wildcats. Wildcats will take over possession here. Here comes that magic number three, Fiona. Let's hold on the attack. Look at her moving right up the field. Turn them wheels on. Stutter steps. Takes the back shoulder on her.
Nice.
She nears the front of the net here. Makes her way to the north side of the field. Passes it off. Here comes Abigail. She got a goal early. She dumps it off to number two, Anka. She's coming around the bend here. Kind of lingering. Trying to get a clear shot on the net. She passes it off. Anna Vogler on the attack.
Nice.
Drops her shoulder, shots,
oh,
bounces
nice.
In, and scores. Anna Vogler with a goal, tying at 3-3. 13:46 to go in the first.
Was that Anna Vogler?
Yes, it was, sir.
And that's a goal by number 23, a senior, Anna Vogler. Making the score, the Oxford Wildcats, 3. The Regina Satellites.
Been exciting, man. Regina's showing out, man. I was watching at warm-ups. I was like, man, we might be going home early, but Regina came to play.
Yeah.
Yeah, they came to play, man. Here's Oxford right back on the attack, winning the faceoff. Come running around the goal is Skylar Laney.
Love to see
it. She comes on the attack, shoots, and deflected by number 22. Good defense there. That was Maddie Cutter, the defensive player for Regina. Pushed her out of bounds. And Oxford takes over. Oh, no. Hold on a minute. Wait. Why did he point that way? What's going on here?
I have not the
slightest. Blow a whistle, young man. Slow these lung lays down. She did she drop or she shoot it? That's Olivia De Soil or Del. Is it, how do you say that one, Jeb?
This one?
Yeah, Del Isola.
Del Isola.
Del Isola. Del Isola. Yeah.
Del Isola.
Del Isola.
Yeah.
Yeah, that sounds right. Olivia De Isola.
I have a question. Does Anika Erickson play soccer?
No. I don't think they can play two sports at one time, Jim.
Oh, probably not. Yeah, that doesn't make sense. But I don't know. I thought I saw the name yesterday. I could just be crazy, though.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. Could you imagine, like, all your extracurriculars, dude, if you were doing two sports? Gosh.
I could not, actually. I don't even think they'll let you.
That's a lot. That's a lot, man. And they're seniors, too. So, you know, what a move from number 9 and an easy goal. Wow. She dropped that shoulder and it was in. And that was Ella, that we don't want to slaughter your name with the goal. Let's see what she says. I'm going to wait and hear what the house announcer says. Let's see how she says that last name. That's a 4-3 lead, by the way. 11:58 to go in the first.
That's a goal by the Regina Satellite. Number 9, a senior, Ella Wyshelski, making the score the Oxford Wildcats 3.
Wyshelski.
Wyshelski.
Wyshelski is what it kind of looks
like. Shizelski?
Shizelski. Shiz. Wyshelski. Yeah, Wyshelski.
Hey, that's better than what I said. I was like, I don't even know what I said. It wasn't good, though. Oh, man. That's 4-3. Regina up 1 over Oxford. But we're moving right up the field on the attack. Ball's loose in front of the net and scooped up there. That was scooped up by Holly Watson, number 25 in goal for the Satellites. Oxford comes right back with it, though. Like, great defense. That's what they really do, play real good defense.
Solid defense.
Yeah, and that keeps them on the attack, man.
Yeah, it really does.
She tracks it down. I was scared she was going to lose that one, Gracie Phelps. She's a middle defender. Also one of the seniors for tonight. Got a whistle against Oxford. And the Satellites will take over at about the 25-yard line. Right on the attack. This is number 6, Zoe Pellucci. Here she comes right back. Look, here she comes on the attack, crossing midfield.
Nice.
With ease. There we go. Whistle. That's going to go against Oxford.
That seems to be happening a lot.
Nice pass. Deep downfield. Pass over the middle. Takes an Oxford bounce. Lucy gets in front of the net there. Lost in the sun, scooped up, still on the ground, playing a little bit of football down there, kicking around like it's a soccer. Got a whistle, stopping play. Going to go against the Satellites. Oxford to take back over.
Nice.
Wyshelski.
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 I think.
I don't know, man. That's a brave soul that goes there. I'm like, hey, I knew I was going to tear it up. Here we come. Look at that. Fiona with the move. She kicks it over to Anka, slowing it down a little bit. You see her took that stutter step spin move on her.
I did.
Been a good game. Been an exciting game.
It has
been real exciting. Yeah, man. I like them battles like that, man.
Yeah.
Keep it moving. Here comes Fiona on the attack. Ooh.
That was a close
almost
one.
Got her own rebound. Look at that. Scooped up by a Satellite, and the whistle's going to go against Oxford, and they will continue to have possession of the ball and move right up from the 30-yard line there, 20-yard line. Setting everybody. Here they come. Another whistle. against Oxford again. Third whistle. Gosh, come on. Can we get down on the field? That young lady's tall, man. Number 11?
Yeah.
She looks taller than everybody else down there. That's Bella. Here she comes now. Got another whistle. God, doesn't she look like a foot taller than everybody else, bro?
She is pretty tall, yeah.
Yeah, she is, dude. Number 11? The girl with the ball right now? Nothing. Wow. Let's see if we can get through the next minute without a whistle. There they go. They're putting them in position. They're like, hold on a minute. You're not in the right position. There we go. Setting it up there. Satellites have the ball. 29-yard line. Pass to the far north side of the field. It's going to go out of bounds. I don't think she's going to track that down, and it's going to go back to the Wildcats. Yes. Get it back down on the side of the field, girls. 7:44 to go here, first half. In the first, 4-3, Regina Satellites over your Oxford Wildcats. Let's go, Blue. Let's go, team. Here we come on the attack. Some are all red. Trying to get across midfield here. Spin move, drops her shoulder. Passes it back to Kylie. 44, get it down the field, young lady. There we go.
Nice.
That's Anna Vogler on the attack. Here she comes. She got to go. She got to go early. Keep going. Split that defense.
There we go.
Four defenders. She's gonna keep on going. Here she. Oh, she lost it. Got a whistle, though. That's going to go against the Satellites.
Nice.
Oxford maintained possession over there on the north side of the field behind the end zone. Starting at about the 0-yard line there. Whistle, and we're back in the business. Nice pass over the middle. Oh, you see that? That was, she was trying there. Defense swing over here on the south side of the field. Trying to stop her. That's number 22, Lexi Yankee. Here she is making her move. Passes over in the middle. Skylar Laney. Oh, she lost it. Got another whistle. Looks like it's going to go against the Satellites. Skylar Laney is going to get a nice free shot here.
Nice.
Let's go, number four. Let's tie it up. 4-4-4. Come on, let's go. Shots in and good. Tie
nice.
Game. 4-4. Way to go, Skylar.
Lovely.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it was.
It's fun when it's neck-to-neck.
I know.
Like
it's exciting, you know. We're just under 6 minutes, 5:59 on the clock, 4-4, right here at the big block O, waiting for the face-off. Seen the official at the scorer's table. Wasn't sure what that discussion was about, but something was going on over there. Waiting for the whistle.
Are they changing the score all the way down there?
Ball is up. No, the scores are kept up here.
Okay, that's
But
I
that
thought.
Is the scorer's table there. They're keeping track of the official tallies there. Nice move. Nice, good defense there. That's Lexi Yankee, 22, moving right up the field.
Yes, she is.
Nice pass there. Ooh, you see her drop that foot and planted and went. Turns, shoots, and
scores.
All right, that's Abigail Snable's second goal of the night. Taking a 5-4 lead is Oxford with 5:32 to go in the first. Yes, it was. Abigail with a big goal to take the lead.
Who scored the point before hers?
Skylar Laney, number four?
Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Abigail Snable. That's her second goal of the night.
making the score the Oxford Wildcats 5, the Regina Satellites 4.
Ball's up.
To see it.
Took a satellite bounce. Ooh, big collision down there in the field. Ball's free, out of bounds, and it'd be taken over by the satellites. It looked like it went out on them, but hey, that's how it goes sometimes. It's the way the cookie crumbles.
That would be so awful. I feel like I would be awkward. How do you think they interact? Like on like as like different teams, like if they collide into each other, like do you think they are like what do you think they do?
Depends on the
just get up and run away.
Yeah, it depends on the situation. You know, I played football and sports in school, and there was a lot of animosity when I was young. I don't know, you young people are a lot nicer than we were, my age group of people. You know,
I've never done anything competitive like to the point where like, I don't know, like I don't know what I would do if I fell over someone on the opposing team.
Got a whistle, out of bounds. The satellites to take over. Yeah, I don't know, man. I was aggressive. It looks like a timeout on the field.
But like
timeout from Regina. Yeah, I don't know, man. Like it depends. You know, if it was accidental. It was accidental. You know, that's one thing.
Yeah.
If it's intentional and you're like and this is going to be a little bit over your head. But when I was watching basketball as a kid, basketball was a lot more of a brutal sport than it is today.
Right.
And you had players like Charles Barkley and Bill Laimbeer, and they were getting the fist fights on the court.
On the court?
On the court, man. I'm talking about like the Malice at the Palace. That stuff happened all the time. It wasn't like a big deal like it is today. They just did that. I don't know, man. Sports were a lot more brutal when I was a kid. Football, all of them, actually. You know, you could even say baseball was a contact sport. Then you know they slide and they put their little spikes up in the air intentionally. You know, I mean, my coach said you slide in a second, make sure you put your foot up. You know, I mean that's the way we were taught, man. I don't know. It's
right.
Nowadays, you know, you know it's sportsmanship, and not to say be a bad sportman. Like you lose,
right.
shake your opponent's hand, they beat you. You know what I mean?
Right.
But you know, we just didn't we didn't like each other. You know what I mean? Like our rival was our rival. We didn't come together and you know hang out or support each other. We didn't like each other. Like hey,
right. And I'm just saying. I feel like it would be awkward.
It would be awkward. I mean, I don't know. I remember I put a hit on a kid, and I didn't feel bad. You know, my coach smacked my helmet. Bow! Good job. You know what I mean? It's like, hey.
Right.
Nowadays, you like, don't touch your helmet and get a concussion, man. I thought I had one when I was in school. I was like, hey, I feel nauseous. And coach told me to run laps, man. Just keep running laps.
Interesting.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's just the whole world's changed so much. That I don't know. You know, they seem pretty friendly. I haven't seen them get too chippy.
Yeah.
The chippiest I've seen in the 2 years I've worked here at the television station was probably hockey.
Yeah, hockey is chippy, yeah.
They don't you remember that one kid, Dan? Dan missed the last game.
Yeah.
This kid gets ejected from the game, leaves the ice, shuts the door, comes back, opens the door that he just shut, and then left. Dude, they had to come over there and shut the door. The kid was mad. Like it was, he was definitely ticked off, and wasn't a good sportsman about it. You know, it just depends on depends on the situation. I would say,
for sure.
Man.
I'm saying, it's
no one
quite
wants
strange.
To hurt each other. No,
right.
No sport. No one wants to see anybody get hurt like
right.
that, like a serious injury. We're back from the timeout, and the satellites are on the attack, intercepted and stolen away by 21. That's Gracie Phelps.
Sheesh.
With a big move. Moving it up, she passes it to Emily Weaver, who's pushing up the field. She gets rid of it to Ava Vogler on the attack. She drops her shoulder, gets a squared up shot on the goal. Ooh, big save, but gets her Ooh. Own rebound. Comes around from behind the net, passes it to the young lady who started all this. Oh, shot right into that net of Holly Watson, senior for the Satellites. Got to stop a play here. I didn't hear the whistle because I was talking too loud probably. That was a nice shot from Gracie Phelps. Like I said, who intercepted the pass to begin with to get him up the field? Here comes the Satellites. Passes over midfield. Outstretched hands is scooped up by a Wildcat. That's Abigail Snable, who's got two goals early.
Hat trick.
Going for her third. There you go, Jeb. Learning the terms. She comes around the bend here behind the goal. Four defenders in her face. Passes it over in the middle. That's Lexi Yankee, who gets rid of it to St. Juliana with a goal from around the bend. That's her second goal of the night, making it 6-4 lead. 2:56 to go in the first.
That was a good play.
Yeah, they practiced that one. Second goal.
That makes two goals for Reyna. The score is the Oxford Wildcats 6 and the Regina Satellites 4.
Here we are at the big block O. Ball's up in the air. Ooh, got a whistle. What happened here? Gonna go against the Satellites. Here comes that magic number 3, Fiona, on the attack. Look at them wheels.
Let's see.
She's burning them. She's like Sonic the Hedgehog. And a goal. And a goal. Fiona Betzel with her first goal tonight. 7-4. Oxford up big. 2:37 to go in the first. I try not to have any favorites, but I like, you know, I'm personal to number 3 anyway. But yeah. She does, man. She's got the wheels. She'll come all the way. I've watched her go 90 yards and score, you know, this year. That's what I said. When I said earlier in the broadcast, we really have a good time doing the girls' varsity lacrosse.
Yeah.
They're a team to be – they're a force to be reckoned with. And I'll tell you what, Fenton, you better watch out next week. You're coming here to the big block O here at OHS. And these girls come to play.
Right.
Look at that. Big move. Nice.
Nice.
Stonewalder. That's Kylie Johnson, number 44, if you didn't know. Got a whistle, though.
She's darn good, too.
Yeah, 44 is real good in that there. We switch them out, though, at halftime.
Yeah.
Yeah, her and Isabella Ball, they tag team that net back down there. Here comes number 3, Fiona. Yep. Look at her. I'm telling you, she was in the end zone.
She must be
that's
in track.
60 yards already, yeah. She went 60 yards past it to St. Juliana. She's got two. Look at her squaring up and shooting. Woo,
man.
Just north of the goal. Out of bounds. Now, see, we maintained it. See, that's my theory is good right now until proven different. When you shoot and it goes out the back, you maintain position.
Yeah.
You pass and then it goes out, you lose it. There's Fiona again, coming around that bend. Almost dropped her shoulder. Passes to Anna Vogler. Here she comes on the attack. Can't get a square shot. It's going to roll out of bounds. And we'll take back over. We maintain possession. So I'm pretty sure that's
That sounds right.
How it goes. Runner a minute now. 7-4. Oxford up. Going to try to make it 8-4. Double up on them, young lady. Let's go. 45 seconds to go. St. Juliana's looking for a pass over the middle. Ball's free in front of the net. Still got a little over 30 seconds to go. Scooped up and lost by 18. That's Samantha. Here she comes. All red.
Nice.
Summer all red with a move. Shot. Oh, it hits the crossbar.
Man.
Still maintained possession over 15 seconds ago. St. Juliana's got something, going to do something. Pass over the middle, just too high for the outreach stick of Ava Vogler.
Man.
Out of bounds, and the Satellites will take back over, but I don't think they're going to inbound it before the time runs out. That's it. That's it for the first half. 7-4, Oxford Wildcats up big.
Love
for
to see
senior
it.
Night. Stay tuned to OCTV's coverage of everything Oxford Athletics.
Stuff started. Looks to be on Oxford's side. And, whoa, early shot by, that's number 14. That is Reina St. Juliana trying to get her hat trick. Out of bounds. I didn't see if that looked out of bounds from the toss, but that would throw Dad's theory out the window. That it, changes possession. Another whistle. That is 21 with the ball right now. That's Angelina. And they're making their way back over to the satellite side. That's number 15 running like that on the attack. And did that get in? I could not see it. I kind of don't think it did, though. It looked like there was a whistle right beforehand. Oh, did they score? Oh, they did score. Oh, I didn't even see. I think it was. It might have been. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. She was on the attack. I didn't see her get it in. I did not notice.
Well, she's that one number I was telling you about. 15 and 16, man. Them two girls.
Yeah.
There she is at the big block O right now at the faceoff. Ball's up. Wildcats come away with it.
Maybe. Yeah.
Yeah, they do. She had to change direction. She forgot which way she was going. She's like, hold on a minute. This is the second half.
That's funny.
Oh, man.
Yeah, it took me a few days to figure it out. It was funny. I was recording soccer, and I was like halfway through the game. I was like, did they change sides, or am I just crazy?
Got a whistle. Going to go against those satellites.
Nice.
Gonna get a free shot here on goal.
Love to see it.
That was a nice pass from St. Juliana. You see her?
I did.
That's a good pass there. She was trying to get her friend to go with the assist here. Yeah. All right, here we go. We're back in business. Nice pass there.
Ooh. Oh, I thought I got stolen.
Ooh, you see how she like shovel swept it to
it
the
did.
Goal? Another whistle. This time it's against Oxford.
Mm. Shoot.
Ooh, took an Oxford bounce. Look at it. There we go.
There's
number six
arm.
Is always there. Kamen Anderley, I tell you what, she plays great defense.
Yeah, she does. Ooh,
got away from her. I told you, the number 15's tough, dude.
Oh.
Nice pass.
Oh,
wide open.
Man.
Yeah, that was easy goal. That's
easy
Lauren
goal.
Gaff again.
Darn.
With her second goal, making it 5-7.
Kylie's still up on goal, too. Vane, switch her out.
6-7, I'm sorry.
Isabella.
6-7.
Oh, 6-7, huh?
Regina.
That's a goal by the Regina. Regina Satellite. Number 24, a junior, Lauren Gaff.
They must have had a talk over halftime.
Second goal of the evening. Oxford Wildcats 7, Regina Satellite 6.
Balls up. Surprised they didn't redo that one. Yep, I knew. Oh, no, they let him go.
Oh, interesting.
Surprised they didn't redo that one. And a Vogler on the attack.
Yeah.
Tried to get something out of nothing. They swarmed in on her, shut her down.
Yes,
nice pass. Oh, God. Free over the middle.
Oh,
ooh,
man.
Ooh, she lost it.
She had it, too.
Yeah. Way to go, number four, to come out of there. Skylar Laney. She's a good player, too, man.
It would suck to be in the middle of one of those skirmishes, let me tell you.
Kicking and swinging that stick, buddy. Yeah.
That's why they did the drop in hockey, because it's like vicious to be down there.
Oh, yeah. Here she comes.
Come
on. That's Neely Taylor again, going coast to coast. She's trying to pull her, a Fiona Betzold, man.
Yeah. Yeah, she is.
She keeps moving. Look at her. She's still coming. She slowed it down a little bit. Nice pass. Out of reach from number seven there. That would be Gracie Groth. Nice spin move there from number 16. Oh, she lost it, though. She's tough, too, man.
Yeah. Yeah, she is.
Yeah, Jessica. Sakura.
She has a... Yeah, she does.
She's got
she
a
has two goals.
Yeah.
Yeah, 15 and 16.
I tell you what, these satellites came to play, man.
Yes, they did.
Like I said, when
did.
I was watching the warm-ups, I was like, yeah.
Yeah, I had, based off the JV game, I was like, wow.
Yeah, well,
you know, that's crazy.
And in warm-ups, too, I was like, we're going to steamroll this team.
I mean, like 16-1, that's crazy, you know? It's been neck to neck, though. Neck to neck, though.
That's definitely good. Oh, look at that. Little lob pass there.
It was pretty, but didn't really go with it.
Didn't work the way they wanted it to,
yeah.
I'm sure. Here's Angelini Giuliani. She makes a pass to number 11, Bella.
I'm confusing my papers. I have them in different orders.
Oh, what a shot. There she goes again. That's number 15, Neely Taylor, with her second goal, tying the game. 7-7. 19:58 to go here in the second half.
Man, I thought, didn't Neely have three?
No, she's only got two.
By the Regina Satellite, number 15, a junior, Neely Taylor. That's her second goal of the night. The Oxford Wildcats, 7. It's a tie game, folks.
Scary business.
Yeah, been a good game. Been close. Been a battle.
Yes, it has.
Fighting and scratching and crawling and all that good noise. Whistle. Ball's in the air. Took a satellite bounce and a whistle against Oxford. Satellites to stay in control. That's Neely Taylor again.
Uh-oh.
Number 15, she here dropping her shoulder, trying to make that move. Why? Oh, I thought she was a spin move. She stopped. Come to a complete stop. Put the brakes on. Passes it up the field. Nice spin move, but she runs into a wall of white.
Love
and
to
is
see
stolen
it.
Away by Kylie Johnson. In goal still. I'm surprised that we don't see Isabella Ball in there.
I know, that's what I said. Pretty crazy.
Ooh,
oh,
nice steal from number 6 there. That was Zoe Pellucci with the steal. Got a whistle. Going to go against Oxford. Somebody didn't like that. Well, they're screaming about that one.
Yeah, it's our lovely, our lovely folks down in JV.
They could lose your voice, dude.
They don't need a voice to play. Oh, yeah.
Here they come on the attack.
It.
There she goes, number 3, Fiona. Turn on them Jets. they're tripping down there, ain't they?
Yeah, I guess that's camaraderie.
Got to root for your team now.
or scream.
Anka behind the net, trying to make something happen. Drops her foot, puts a foot down, tries to drop her shoulder, shots on goal, hits the post, free over the middle, and scooped up by Holly Watson. Holly Watson playing a good game. Whistle. Got a penalty against Oxford. She's telling the move down the field. Holly Watson must be the field general down there. She's a senior for the Satellites. Ooh, way to be there, number 10. Way to be there. That's Rachel Albright.
JV's loving it.
She's a senior. Pass over the middle. Just a little bit out of reach there for St. Juliana. Ball's up. Across the 30. Scooped up. Nope. Wait a minute. Still free.
They're trying. Oh, man.
Ball still, there it is. Skirmish. Up in the air. And a whistle. Yeah. Going to go against the Wildcats.
Mm. Boo.
Here come the Satellites. Ooh, good defense there. Yeah, that's how you play, 22.
Love
that's what you
it.
Do.
There we that's go.
Lexi Yankee with the big move.
Vroom, vroom.
Yep, Fiona. I ain't even got to see a jersey number. I seen her moving.
Yep.
She's like, whoop, turn on them Jets. I'm like,
it's crazy. These like just kicking off the ground, you know.
Ooh, look at her. She's tough too, man.
Yeah.
Good pass. Even better pass, St. Juliana. Oh, and she scores. There's a hat trick. That's the one we were waiting for. Senior night, baby. Number 14 with 3 goals tonight, 8-7. Wildcats up big, 16:55 to go in a second.
Love to see it. That's got to be special, you know, hat trick on your senior night.
Oh, yeah, senior night.
Oxford Wildcats, 8. And the Regina Satellites, 7.
You remember when she scored 5 goals in that one game?
Yeah.
Yeah, she can play, man.
Yes, she can. She's fierce, that's for sure. Like you said, this team, you know, huge force to be reckoned with. We've kicked some lacrosse butt this year.
Absolutely. There's a couple heartbreakers in there.
Yeah,
though.
Yeah.
A couple heartbreakers. That's because you know it's like a smart 6-year-old.
Yeah.
You forget that they're 6.
Yeah.
Because of how smart they are. When their team's that good when and they don't perform like they normally do, you're like, man, what's going on here?
Right.
They build you up, man. You're like, oh.
Right.
You got to watch that young lady, though. She might get her a hat trick, too. She's coming around the bend there. That's Neely Taylor. I told you guys earlier, 15 and 16, I see them, man. You can just tell the intensity, you know, on the field.
Yeah.
She just went 360 on him. Went all the way around the goal. You see that?
I did.
She passes off to number 16, Jessica Sikora. That's their team right there, Lauren Gaff. See, it went them three. Yeah. All three got 2 goals, too.
Yeah.
Good pass. Way to be there. Number 6, Zoe Pellucci. Now, she's made some plays earlier. Hasn't translated to the scoreboard, but she's made a couple plays there.
Yeah, for sure.
Kind of lingering around. Nice pass over the middle. Lost opportunity there for the Satellites.
A whistle, though, and I'm not sure what for.
No, it was against Regina. Wildcats take back over. Kylie Johnson kicks it out over the middle. That's number 22. Lexi Yankee. Here she comes. And she kicks it up to Anna Vogler. Anna Vogler's a good player, too. Look at her.
She's
a senior. Shots blocked there. Great block from Holly Watson. Ball's loose and still in play, though.
Love to see it.
Here comes Anna for round 2. She passes it. Intercepted there by Holly Watson. She's a good player.
Yes, she is.
She's, you know, she made some good plays there in the goal. Yeah, you got to watch her.
Neely Taylor seems to be, like, you know, right where she needs to be every time.
Put yourself, that's what good players do.
Yeah.
Put themselves in the good positions. Whistles against Oxford. 14:30 to go here, second half. 8-7, Oxford up by 1. It's been a nail-biter, though. It's been close. Seesaw battle here.
Yes, it has been.
Kind of. Oh, she lost it. Look at that. Way to be there. Good defense from Emily Weaver. She pushes it up the field. Takes an Oxford bounce. Ooh, almost lost it. She keeps moving. That's Gracie Phelps, 21. Big-time player here for Oxford. Kicks it to St. Juliana. Look at her. Turning wheels on. Drop her shoulder. Got a whistle, though. Going to be against the Satellites. Get a free shot here at about the 16-yard line there. Oops, they moved her back a little bit. Going to kick her back to the 20. Waiting for the whistle. Here we go. St. Juliana puts a move on her. Ooh, hit the pole. Gets her own rebound. Stays with it. Good follow through there, young lady.
Ooh.
Pass behind the goal. Takes a bad bounce.
Run.
Scooped up by the Satellites and out of bounds.
So do we take possession? Or
no,
do they
Satellites maintain possession.
Okay.
They're going to inbound that bad boy over there on the sideline. That's Angelina Giuliani, number 21. 12:52 to go here. Like I said, up one. Score's been tight, been close.
Yes, it has.
Tight
been.
Like hallways, man, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
That's Anna Vogler. Oh, another whistle. This one's against the Satellites. Going to get a free shot here. Try to make it 9-7. Try to go up two.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
Come on, 2-3. Big shot right here. Oh, hold on a minute. All right, here we go. Oh, they knocked it out of the net. Going to be a whistle. Going against the Satellites again. They're just letting her get closer and closer to that goal, man. He threw his hands up. Like, what do you want me to do? Big shot on goal, and it's
nice.
In.
Nice.
That's how you do it. Going up to Anna Vogler with her second goal tonight. Another senior for the Wildcats. Making it a 9-7 lead. Just under 12 minutes.
That makes two goals for Anna, making the score the Oxford Wildcats 9 and the Regina Satellites 7.
Face off right here to Big Block O. Ball set. Whistle blows up in the air. St. 21, that's Gracie Phelps. She comes on the attack. Look at her go. She turned them wheels on them. Jets just kicked in the overdrive there. Ooh.
She's good at that.
Yeah, snatching
it over, out of the air.
You talking about Holly Watson?
Yeah.
Got a whistle. Looks like it's going to go against the Satellite. Abigail Snable comes on the attack. She's going to bring it around the back of the end zone, around the back of the net. She passes it off to Anka. Anka tries to make a move. Being held at bay. She drops her shoulder, makes a square shot, and
nice.
A goal. There's one for Anka. Taking the lead up 3-10-7. Oxford up. 11:05 to go in the second.
I did not know Anika was a junior.
The Regina Satellite, 7.
Man, look how tall Lovin is, man.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, she's got to be a good foot taller than everybody else out there.
Yeah, she's pretty tall.
Face off of the Big Block O. Ball's up.
God,
should have been easy for 11. Yeah. You know what I mean? Just reach up over everybody. But Oxford comes away with it.
Gosh, look at how red those poor things are.
Rachel Albright. Yeah, it's cold, man. It was a cold morning.
It's been a cold day. Coldest day, I think, of the week.
Good defense.
No, I think tomorrow's supposed to be like really cold, and then it's supposed to get warmer again.
That's Rachel Albright. St. Juliana. Here she comes. Look at her. Drop her shoulder. Nice. Turns to the left hand. Just south of the goal. Going to go out of bounds. Wildcats to take back over. It's Wildcats ball. What? Hold on a minute there.
I thought it happened earlier, this half two. It looked like they threw it, and it didn't go back to them.
Ball don't lie. See how we come right back with it?
That's why.
That's exactly why we got it right back, because it was wrong. The call was wrong, Bob. The price is wrong, Bob. There we go. Get there, ladies. Don't let it go out. There you go.
Nice way
to slow down. Oh, come on now. Didn't go out of bounds. Is it the red line? It must be the red line. Here come the satellites.
It's not red for soccer, is it?
It's yellow. No, it's the white line. Nice spin move. That's Jessica. Good pass upfield to number 10. Carolyn Kravitz.
Just under 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Things are getting dicey.
That was a nice pass. That was a nice opportunity there and missed it, though. But they set that up nice and neat. It just couldn't come to fruition for them there.
Do you know what I noticed?
What's that?
Number 24 for the Satellites. That's Lauren Gaff.
Mm-hmm.
She makes a lot of plays. I've seen her like get into position and raise her net. And not a lot of people throw it like they haven't like...
utilize her like they should?
Yeah.
Big shot on goal. Just a hair wide there. That was Ava Vogler. Yeah, no, she's got two goals, too.
Yeah.
She's down there posted up right now.
Like earlier, I saw she got in front of the goal, and even like Kylie was in front of goal, and she had her net raised. And
ooh, that just crept in there.
Man.
Fiona Betzel with her second goal of the evening, making it 11-7, 8:24 to go in the second. You see her?
Yeah.
It hit her stick.
She plays a senior.
Yeah, she's a good player. She went to shoot it.
Mm-hmm.
The defensive player put their stick up, stopped her shot.
Mm-hmm.
Ball crept out of the net, fell on the ground, and rolled in. And that
man,
sheer force of pushing forward with the shot. Is how that goal happened. Look at that. That's right. No harm, no foul. Keep moving, Oxford. Let's do it again. There's Fiona. Here she comes right back at him.
Vroom, vroom.
On the attack. Oh, she stutter-stepped. Nice fake, dude. She could have turned them jets on and split that defense.
I don't know why
she let up. She let up on him. I don't know. That killer instinct wasn't there that time. But she could have, man.
Oh, she could have.
Hindsight's always 20/20, you know? Yeah. It's easy for us to say up here.
Right.
You know what I mean?
You know, it's hard when you're down there.
Nice pass. There was Gracie Phelps with the pass to Anka. She comes on the attack. Can't quite split the defensive. Drop that back shoulder and spin. Boom. Yeah. All the defensive players were on the side of the field here.
Yeah.
Here she comes around the corner on the attack. Shots on goal, little behind.
Come on.
There goes number 3, Fiona, spins around.
Vroom, vroom.
Here she comes. Oh, come on now. Hit her in the face. What? They called that on the Wildcats. Get out of town. Oh, no, they didn't. They green carded her, okay. Because she hit her in the face with a stick, dude.
You got hit wrong.
Yeah, I was like, hold on a minute there. I thought he was giving the ball away to the other team. I said, no.
Goodness, Fiona, you weren't supposed to get hit in the face.
Yeah.
Can of that.
She just look at her. Strolling through the park.
Yeah. I was just going to say. La-di-da.
She's on a stroll. You know? Yep. Hey, there she goes.
A brisk walk.
She went in with the intensity held up. Nice pass over the middle there.
Run, come on.
Trying to set something up. They're trying to get them off their rocker there.
Yeah.
Trying to open it up there. Nice spin move and a
nice
goal.
Nice.
Easy goal there.
Yeah.
That's number 7. Evelyn Salden with her first goal of the evening. Taking the score from 11 to 12. 7. 12-7. Oxford up big. 6:29 to go here in the second half.
That's a goal by the Oxford Wildcat. Number 7, a junior. Evelyn Salden.
That JV team is hype.
Yes, they are. I wonder how come they don't normally stick around to watch the games.
Senior night, I don't know.
Oh, they have little signs for them and stuff, too.
Ball's up. Satellites come away with it. That's number 15, Neely Taylor. She's trying to do something. She's like, hey, man, I can't keep letting
that. Oh, man.
There it is. That's a hat trick for that young lady. She's like, I can't just keep letting this happen. That makes it 12-8. 6:19 to go here in a second. No goal. They waved it.
Really? That's got to be frustrating.
That's a goal by the Regina Satellites. Number 15, a junior, Neely Taylor.
They waved it. I know. I think the score's wrong. There you go. They fixed it back now. Now the score's right. 12-7. 6 minutes to go. Just a hair over 6 minutes. Got a whole lot of sideline coaching going on down there. A lot of calls coming in from the bleachers here. Yeah, I don't know. It's kind of like I don't know what happened. It's all sullen on the field all of a sudden, right? Like there's not a lot of movement going on. It's like, hey, there's still 5.5 minutes to go.
Right.
You know what I mean? You're not – Regina's not down that much for them to lose all momentum there. Got a whistle. Going to go against Oxford. And here comes Regina. Oh, they lost it, though. Is that stop and play? I didn't hear a whistle, but it looks like there's a stop and play. Did you hear a whistle?
I know. I did not.
Here we go. Okay, there they go. Taking it out of the back of the end zone there.
Okay.
I was like, what is going on here, man? That's a lot of time that just went off the clock, too, there. That's Bella bringing it in. Another whistle. Come on, ref, let him play, man. It was like that early in the game.
Yeah.
The very first, like, 5 minutes, they just kept blowing a whistle.
It's number 6. That's...
Yeah, Zoli Pelucci.
Pelucci. Is it Pelucci?
Pelucci. P-A-O-L-U-C-C-I. Pelucci. Free shot on goal. That's number 5 there.
Hey,
Olivia.
Coon, it's us.
She tried to lob it in there. You see that?
Yeah.
Oh, that wasn't Olivia. That was Zoe. Zoe, right?
Yeah. That looks like Zoe.
It just depends. Both spelled the same. Just
yeah.
Fiona come bring it out of the end zone. Look at her. Stutter step. Turns on a little bit of wheels.
Pass hits number 4. That's Skylar Laney.
Mm-hmm. She got
a
goal.
She has a goal, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Here she comes on the attack. Ooh, bounce shot. Bounces off the side of the rail there.
You know, that happens more than you think. That, like, that sounds like a once in a lifetime. Like, I can't believe it bounced off the net, but it happens.
Crossbar. It hit the crossbar a lot, too.
Yeah.
Look at that. She turned on a jet. She tried to bounce shot, just couldn't do it. A little high. That was number 19, Ava Vogler, with that shot. Oxford brings it out of the back of the end zone. Evelyn Salden slowly working it. Just under 3 minutes to go here in the second half. It's not looking good for Regina.
No, it is not.
Nice deflection there from number 5, Olivia.
Who?
De La Sola.
Cleats are best used when walking on the ground and not other people.
The head coach Trevor Marshall's done a great job with these ladies this year.
For sure.
And the assistant coach Macy McDevitt, you know, have led these girls to a playoff game next week against Fenton. Like I said earlier in the broadcast, if you come out, you'd be in surprise for a special treat, because not only are the girls' varsity lacrosse team playing, but the boys' varsity lacrosse team's also playing, and they're playing against Troy. So you come out here and support both teams for the doubleheader.
Yeah.
Playoffs here next week.
Lunch on all-you-can-eat popcorn, sold separately.
Sounds like false advertisement there, young man.
Yeah.
Nice pass over the middle. That's from Gracie Phelps to Ava Vogler. Look at her. There you go. Keep moving. Keep on moving. Ooh. St. Juliana had an open chance on goal. They kept her head down. She's in with the goal anyway. She didn't need to pass. She took it all the way home.
Yes, she did.
That's Ava Vogler's first goal tonight. She had to get one in for senior night.
Yes, she
making
did.
Making it 13-7. Oxford up. Minute 29 to go here in the second half. Ain't looking good for the Satellites.
Number 19, a senior, Ava Vogler.
They are pumped down there.
I like that one, yeah.
Where are they at? They move on us?
Did they move? Oh, man. I heard them.
Yeah, I can't see them, but there are. There's a bunch of seniors heading this way with their ribbons on, caps and gowns. Looks like some medals, too. Got some hardware down there.
Interesting.
Got to redo that one. Take it back to the big block O. Ball's up. Takes an Oxford bounce. But Regina stays with it. That's number 6. Zoe Pellucci on the attack. Look at her go.
Man.
She picked it up and did her own thing. Good deflection there. Great, great defense from number 11, Reagan Brightshoe. She's a senior defensive player for Oxford. Ball's loose around the 45 there. Still alive.
Man, that's a struggle.
Yep, got
little
a whistle.
Little under a minute.
Got a whistle. Looks like it's against Oxford. Satellites to take over with under a minute to go. Ain't looking good. I think the time has done expired.
Yeah.
What's that old song? The time has come today.
Immediately smashed back up by us anyway, though.
Yeah, that's it, man. We're under 30 seconds. It ain't looking good.
No.
Let's get one more for the road, ladies. Come on. 20 seconds to go. We can get one for the road. Five seconds. They're just going to hold it, and time's going to run out. That's going to do it for this game. Oxford won 13-7.
Nice.
And that's the end of the game, folks. The Oxford Wildcats 13, the Regina Satellites 7. What an amazing night for senior night for the girls' lacrosse team. A great win, hard playing by both teams.
Well, that was quite a game there.
Yeah.
What a senior night. What a senior night for Reina St. Juliana, she had a hat trick. Lots of goals for seniors. Lots of goals, period. 13-7 was the final score. Oxford, you know, the first half it was close.
Yeah.
Come out of the gates, you know, Oxford was in the driver's seat. Towards about the last 5 minutes there, it seemed like we pulled all the wind out of the sails, you know, of the visiting Satellites. It was a fun game. It was a good time.
It was a fun game, yeah.
Glad to be here for senior night. Hopefully we can make it back for some of these playoff games. We'll see what we can't do. For OCTV, I'm Joseph Calhoun.
I'm Jebediah Calhoun.
Got Dan the Man's Weiss back behind the camera. He's going to put this one together for you. We'll see you next time or next year. I don't know, but have fun in the meantime. Thanks for watching OCTV.